What is up, everybody? It is Gorilla Man back with another Farming Simulator 2017 single player. And in today's video, we are going to try and get our cow production somewhere around the 100% mark. So basically, what I've been doing is I've been looking around here, trying to figure out what I can do. So right now, I'm putting stuff into the bin over there, and I'm mixing the straw and everything. And we're also going to try and get some power food, and we're basically just going to see if we can make these cows hit 100% for this video. I don't know if we'll be able to do it this video, maybe next video. Probably don't have enough time, but we will try our hardest to do it. But right now, I'm just running around picking up some of these extra hay bales that I just left sitting over there. Tossing them into this guy, and then we're just gonna attach the hitch up to this, see what it is currently at, because I don't know. All right, so 100% in that mixing ratio. So then we're gonna need to get some power food, and power food, if I saw in here, you can optimize milk production for your cows by feeding them a total mix ration from mixer wagons, which is what we have. So hay, silage, straw, and whey, and blend them into a complete ration. This mix then consists of base food 60% and then 40% power food. So we need to mix it in with, it looks like grass. So we need to mix it with grass and power food. So if I go in here, I go to animals. Where's animals at? Dun. I think I'm missing it. I know it's in here. There it is. Will it be in here? She takes straw bales and uses them to cover ground for cat. Ooh, that'd be nice to use though. So I'll have to remember to come back and get that. Oh, this one automatically does everything for you. All right, where is it? Pallets, pig food, big bag. All right, how do you get the power food? All right. So we're trying to figure out how to get power food right now. So base food and power food. So we need to get some of that and some of that. All right, I'm gonna go find out and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so I think I just figured it out. Drop this off, hop out of here. So to do it, we need to fill it up with hay and silage. So to get hay is when you have to cut everything and then you use a tedder to turn the grass over so it can dry completely. So we are going to go buy a tedder, which is what I think it's called. Uh-oh, back. Mowers. That's still a mower used to cut grass. Ooh, that's a big one. And we got some of our zero turn mowers in here, but that's not what we're, there it is, tedders right there. So we're just going to pick this guy. We'll straight up buy it. So we got ourselves a tedder, and then we need to make silage. But to make silage, so you have to turn chaff into silage, and you need to dump it into a clamp silo either next to the cow stable or at the biogas. All right, so it's over here, which is right over there. So you dump it over there. Once the silo is at least 10% full, you can compact the heat by driving over it repeatedly with a tractor. All right, seems pretty easy. Afterwards, you can cover the silo and start the fermenting process. The resulting silage can be picked up with the front loader equipped with a silage fork, all right, and dumped into a mixer wagon or directly into the feeding trough. All right, that doesn't sound too bad. You can also directly make silage from hay bale by using the bale wrapper. All right. Well, that doesn't seem too terrible. So let's just look for baling technology. Look for a bale wrapper. So this is the packs grass bales in foil so they can ferment into sludge. So I think we're just going to go with this way. This way seems a lot easier than packing everything into there. Yeah. Turns grass bales into foil so they can. All right, yeah. So we'll pick up one of these. Oh, that is $42,000. We're going to rent that. That guy is expensive. All right, so we got the tedder for the hay. And then we're also going to make silage from hay bale using a bale wrapper, which I think I know what we need to do. Packs grass bales in foil. All right, so then do I need something to make grass? So I need to pick up the grass hay bales. Great demand at Denton Bakery for canola. Oh, that's not too bad. All right, so we'll tab back here. We got some of our workers going to town. I think we can grab the tedder with this truck. I'm assuming it's just a hitch. It didn't look too bad. So we're just going to head over with our Dooley Duramax with that sick blue color. I think I need to wash it. It's actually a little dirty. Look both ways. And let's go. So we're going to pick up the tedder, and then we're going to cut some grass, and we're going to use the tedder on it. We're going to let that dry out, then we're going to pick it up with the forager, and it should be hay. It said that the hay is a slightly lighter color than the regular grass. And then we are going to, basically while the hay is, or the grass is drying into hay, we are going to pack more grass into that bale packer and make silage. Probably gonna take some time for this to like go through the process and complete, so probably turn this into another video where we finish the process. But basically this will just probably be us just getting there and getting everything done. Alright, so looks like everything is on hitches except for the tedder. I don't think the tedder's on a hitch. That's not good. Alright, so we'll just pick up this guy and we'll take this one back. Uh-oh. Am I just really far off? There we go. Yeah, I was just really far off. Alright, so we got this one. And let's just see how it does it. Okay, so yeah, you have to have the hay bales down, and then it'll grab them, and then you can drop them off. Alright, I hope our baler... Here, I'm going to... Went a little haywire there. I'm going to check and see if our baler that we have... Yep, it can do grass. And yeah, we have this one right here. Yeah, we can do grass. Alright, so that's good. That's really, really good. That's what I was hoping for. I wonder what the demand at the Denton Bakery is. Let's check really quick. $2,000 for canola. It's not too bad. I got over on field 12. I'm planting soybeans because it was corn last time. Field 15 is currently being plowed. Field 14 is planted, and I can't remember what is on field 14 at the current moment. But we'll drive right by it, so we will find out. Oh, I love this truck. It's so sick. All the other ones that we were going to choose were pretty sick, but I like this one a lot. I'll probably change trucks a lot or buy another one soon. What did I plant? Oh, I planted corn right here. All right, that's what I did. All right, that's a pretty good choice. So, yeah, this one is just finished, actually. So, basically, once he gets done planting over there, we'll have him hop over here and probably plant some soybeans or something. Maybe some wheat. I'm not sure yet. Let's actually back this guy up. And we're gonna leave this right here. Looks like... So last time we did it right here and we cut all this grass. It's a nice wide open area. It works pretty well. So we're probably gonna do that again. Yeah, we're probably gonna do that again. Alright, so we'll snag the blue tractor. And then we'll just drop off this right here out of our way. And I'm gonna drive back to the shop really quick, everybody. I'm gonna cut that out. It's gonna be way too much driving for one episode. So I'm gonna drive her to the shop really quick, and I will see you guys back here with the tether. Alright, everybody, we are back here. Finally, we went and picked up the tether, and sadly, it started mowing on us about a quarter of the way back, which kind of sucks. So there's that. I've never actually seen it rain in Farming Sim before, so this is pretty cool. It actually has like the trees moving quite a bit and everything. I don't know, I really like it. I mean, other than the fact that it makes my game all foggy and stuff, but it looks pretty cool. Adds pretty dynamic effect to the game. But we're gonna get started here. We're just gonna start, make sure this mower's down all the way. Yep, there we go. So we're basically just gonna get around mowing everything. I'm just gonna time lapse this because this will be really, really boring for you guys to watch. So I'm just gonna time lapse it up real, real quick, like with some good music on, and I'll be right back. Sorry, I kept you waiting forever and a day. But now we're out here together with nothing standing in our way. Can you feel the attraction? Feel the attraction. Can you feel it between us? This energy's inside us like electricity. Alright, everybody, we just finished mowing. Oh, close this guy up, shut it off. So we just finished mowing and using the tether to turn up all the grass. We'll drop that off. Alright, so we got all, and it stopped raining. Yeah, look at that. So we got all of this grass currently flipped over into hay, and it is now drying. We'll just wait a little bit. Let's see if this says anything. No, doesn't really say much. So yeah, it'll turn the grass. So basically now it's just a waiting game, and we'll wait and see for all of this to turn over. But until that time, we will mow another patch probably right here, and I probably won't time lapse this one. We'll probably just mow another patch right here. I'll run over. Where is the baler? I'll grab the baler because we're probably gonna need the baler to pick up the grass, turn it into bales, and then wrap it with the other guy, with the what's it called? I can't even remember. But it ferments the grass and turns it into silage so that we can put all of that into the mixer and make a power food for our cows. And hopefully that'll boost their production. Maybe 100%, maybe not 100%. I'm not sure. Hopefully 100%. That would be the goal. But if it doesn't, that's okay. So we're probably just going to make 5 or 6 bales with this guy. This thing looks really, it runs really good on this, on the Duramax. Alright, so we'll hop back into this one. And then, oops, sorry. We'll just back up and attach. And then we're also gonna be wanting to get another mower sometime soon. I'm gonna push this out of the way. I'm probably gonna get us one of those zero turn mowers that you guys have. You guys maybe you've seen a video on them with the squad, or maybe I can't remember if I posted a video, but yeah, it's zero turn mowers and all that kind of stuff, and it makes everything a lot easier. So I might end up purchasing one of those. It is a mod, I'm pretty sure. I don't think any of them are not mods, but it'll make everything a lot easier, and it's really cool. I mean, For the small amount I am mowing in real life, I would probably be using a zero turn and not something attached up to a tractor. They both still yield the same results. They both still cut the grass and everything. So I'm probably going to go with a zero turn sometime soon here, mainly because it'll just be quicker, a lot easier, a lot less pain in the butt for this guy, because like this one's pretty annoying to have to use. It's not bad or anything, it's just kind of annoying. If I would have gotten a better one, it probably would have been a lot better for me, but I didn't, so it's okay. So we're just gonna make a few laps here, and then we're just gonna go back and forth with the baler, bale up some of this grass, and then we'll use that. Hopefully we can get, I'm going for 3 bales out of it, and then we'll just pick them up. I think we can pick them up with the transporter that we have over there. It picks up round bales, and I'm pretty sure it'll make these into round bales. So I'll just pick those up with the transporter, and we'll pull them with us and take them to the cows. Hopefully by the end of this video, we'll have all of that done and ready. Probably not the hay though. I don't think the hay will be finished quite yet. Maybe it is. I'm not sure yet. I'll just have to try it out and look and see if it ends up sprouting out some hay when I use the forager on it. So we're just about done here. This is getting me a little dizzy just going around in circles. Alright, we'll hit up this last center part here. Alright, oh, I missed quite a few spots. And don't pay me to mow your lawns. That was not a good idea. Alright, there we go. So we got this. I'll drop this off. We'll hop over to the Duramax. Alright, unfold baler. Lower pickup. There we go, now it's on. Is it on? Maybe. Like I'm doing something wrong here. Nope, because that still works. But I'm not picking that up. Maybe, let's see if I can pick up the hay. No, not picking up the hay either. Here, let me drop this. Let me grab the Cummins, because I'm pretty sure I've used the Cummins before with no problem. Alright, let me see if this one works. If the Cummins works, I'm gonna be confused and happy, but what the heck? Okay, so it looks like I can only use the baler with the Cummins. Yep, can see. Alright, so note to self, we can only use the baler with the Cummins, so we have to hold on to the Cummins, don't sell it. Never sell it. Always got to keep it. And or keep it until we find out something else that works. I mean, I know probably the tractors work, but... Uh-oh. I feel like the Cummins is just a lot... It's a lot easier. It's a lot faster. It's a powerhouse. It's got horsepower. I mean, don't get me wrong. Tractors have horsepower too, but... I think this probably has a V8 in it. I don't know what it has in it right now. Alright, 50%. We might get 2 bales out of this. Oh, that's a really tough backup. So we might get 2 bales out of this. I hope we get 2 bales out of this. Alright, we're just gonna snag these few loose ends. Take a tight turn. Alright, I'm really curious to see how this is going to pop out. Mainly because I always thought if I did the grass, I always thought it was already pre-packaged. Like, I figured it would be packaged when it pops out either way. So it's going to be kind of weird for me to see it. Alright. Oh yeah, so we're only going to be able to get one with this. I need to find a better spot to collect grass at, though, because this spot is awful. You guys probably are gonna agree with me. I need this a little bit. There we go. All right. Oh, sick. All right, so just drops that out. All right, we'll close you up here. All right, we'll drop this off. The hay might be ready, actually. I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure. All right, so we will unfold. Unfold the bale wrapper. And all right, let's watch this thing do its magic. Oh, that's pretty sweet. What happened? Oh my gosh, look at it go. What do I do now? Unload round bale? Why? Does it kick it right off? Oh, that's pretty sweet. Alright, alright. Won't deny. Alright, now we're just gonna run over here. Let's fold this guy up so it doesn't get caught on the wall. Alright, we're gonna hop out. Hop in Zedera Max. And we're gonna see if we can pick that guy up. I hope we can use this. Alright, looks like we can use this. Oh yeah, there we go. Alright, so we got one. That looks like it will have to do for now. So that is that. So then we need to get the silage. No, that is the silage. Hay. So use a tedder to cut grass. Hay looks slightly lighter than grass. So then we'll actually no. So we'll stay here and we'll wait. And we'll pick up. Ooh, did that change color? Oh no, it's just really weird because it's really far away. Alright, so what color does it say? Hay looks slightly lighter and less saturated than cut grass. Alright, so I'm assuming it's just ready then automatically. I don't really think we have to do much to it. So let's hop in the Duramax. Or not the Duramax, the Cummins. And basically, let's just repeat, rinse and repeat that process, except for it'll be hopefully hay bales that we pick up. All right. All right, so we're picking it up. It is picking it up, at least. I hope it picks it up as hay, though, not grass. Because this could still be grass, I think. I don't know. I'll find out. You guys probably know this, and you're probably just cringing at everything I'm saying, but I think we're doing it right. Yeah, I definitely need to find a better spot to mow, though, because all these curves and stuff are just killing me. Oh, look at that. We already almost got one. I'm gonna be sad though if it's just grass, mainly because I've wasted some of my precious hay. Alright, there we go. Just about there. We'll just cut across this. 86, 87. 90. Alright, yeah, we'll finish it right here on this pass. This is also spread out. It looks so weird. Alright, so I finished it. We'll back it up. Let's see what this one looks like. Alright, we'll close. Object too heavy. Alright. So let's turn this to operating position. Let's go pick that guy up. All right, so now we have a thing of hay, hopefully. I think it's hay. And then we have a thing of grass that is being turned into silage. From using the wrapper. All right. We're gonna take this, we're just gonna haul this over here. Ooh, and actually before we run off, let's get the harvester going. Uh-oh. Let's go switch the heads on the harvester really quick. We'll get the harvester going and get him pumping out some corn. We'll get that going. All right. Is this one already planted? No. This one's freshly plowed, so we need to plant this one. All right, we need to plant some sunflowers in this one. There's not been any sunflowers in that one yet. So that will be... Once that one finishes... Did that guy finish up at 12? All right, yeah, so we finished up there. So we'll just have to go over there really quick. Once we get back, detach that header. There we go. Ooh, my combine is super low on gas. Oh, I hoped one of the workers would end up filling it up, but I guess they have not filled it up yet. And also get to see, once this combine starts harvesting everything, I'll get to see if I was able to fix that glitch I was having the last few times we've done some episodes, because I don't know. I went and I took away a few of the mods that were like just enabled, so I hope it worked. All right, we will unfold and lower. So we'll be able to tell in the first few seconds as he gets going. Because we'll let him do that. All right, let's just watch him for a bit. See if I get any kind of lag. I don't think I've been getting any lag, but you never know. All right, it looks pretty solid right now, guys. Yeah, I think we're good for now. Oh, spoke too soon. Spoke way too soon. All right, so we still got a little bit. It's okay though. Let's take these two bales. Hopefully that one is fermented enough and is in silage, or silage, however you want to say it. And then we got the other one that is converted into hay already. So I don't really know if there was that much of a difference in the appearance of the hay bale to the grass bale, but hopefully we did it right. I think we did it right. I hope we did it right. So if I did it wrong, guys, just let me know down below, because I probably won't be able to finish this entire episode, or this entire process in just this one episode. So you guys let me know. Tell me if I'm doing anything wrong, just write it right down below. Ooh, and it's getting really dark out too. It's 19:20. Ooh, they about T-boned me. All right. Oh, that's the forager. Let's just do this. Ooh, hey, there's some grass we can pick up here. Oh yeah, and you guys also said that was grass in the last video, not poop. I thought it was poop. So you guys definitely corrected me on that one. Alright. This takes forever. Alright. Unload bales. Alright, so that should still go. Is this attached? Oh, yep. I got a little bit of lag there. Alright. So, we're just gonna try it. See what happens. If it doesn't work, tell me what I'm doing wrong, everybody. If it doesn't work. Or, I mean, even if it does work, tell me if I'm doing anything wrong, but... Alright, so hopefully that one should be converted to silage. I hope it converted it. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Alright, there we go. Oh! It took it. I don't know what did it take it as. Let's check it out. Let's see if it took it as the hay. Alright, so it fell right in that ratio of hay, and it looks like we have way too much of the other stuff. Of the, straw. Alright, well, maybe we can still put this in there. Oh. It does not want to pick it. Oh, there we go. It just slid right onto the forks. Did not want to pick it up, though. Alright, come on, baby. Let's see if we can get this. Alright. Let's see what it took that as. Oh, I just dented the front end of my truck. Alright, come on, let's see. Let's see. Ooh, I need a lot more. Turn on the mixer wagon. Alright, so it looks like I need a lot more of the silage, which is a bummer, because I was hoping we'd be able to fill somewhat up with some power food, but looks like we're not going to be able to do that in this video, so I'm probably going to have to end the video here, guys. We got a lot of work done, though. We figured out a lot of stuff. So, yeah, like I said before, though, comment down below. If you guys see anything I'm doing wrong, just let me know, and I'll correct it for next video. So, thank you, everybody, for watching. Leave a like if you liked the video. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. And I'll see everybody in the next video.